Hello everyone. Today I have this Tampa Rollers hand rolled cigar. It's a mild. This is called the Mild Milenio, which has the makings to be a great cigar the way it looks. Cocoa-y. Like a baking cocoa, maybe. Grassiness. Yeah, overall grassy base. Very nice overall notes on it. Yeah, it's got the band on it. Just give it a cut. Good. Excellent draw from the start. Let's see. Those little things get my goat sometimes. I'm telling you. Can't see it for shit. Alright, there we go. The sunlight blocks it out. That's the problem. Very good, huh? As you can tell, this is going to be a very mellow, mild taste in smoke right here. It's got a good grass flavor at the beginning of it here. Some coffee cream notes in here, too. Very good. I had this, I think, one other time where I had something from this brand, but it was really good. Very, if I recall it correctly. That was more of a getter, too, when I had these. So what does that say? I had like one when I was a beginner. It's a traditional roller. Nothing fancy about it. Under $7. It's like a light, it's like a mostly coffee cream and grassy flavor right now. But I'll check back in a little bit. Alright, I'm back. Very nice, even burn. It's just got a nice, classic, mild tobacco flavor. Like something that a lot of... It just takes you back in time, you know? It's got that taste to it. Like that old Ybor City type flavor to it is what you will be reminded of when you smoke this. Look at the tobacco. There could be some shavings in there, I don't know. But, or it could be at the very least a mixed filler cigar, I'm thinking. But it's minimal veins in it, not many. Even burn. It's a very good even burn on this. It's much better than the other one I had where I had to struggle with it. You know, the last one that I reviewed. It's got that mild, old-time, creamy kind of flavor, you could say. with a little bit of nuttiness coming in, and very soft, but it's very nice too. Great smoke output, as you see. I'm about 20 minutes in, I would say. Look at the even burn on it. Going nicely. I'll update in a bit, though. I'm back. Ash just dropped. Still a very even burn, though. Like, I'm still that same creamy coffee texture with the grassiness and then some of the nuttiness that's coming in also. A little bit of cedar, maybe. You can tell smoke output is great throughout. Still, no problems whatsoever on this. Retrohale, like an orange, like a zesty, orangey lemon. With a little spice, not too much spice, a little bit though. Maybe a little clove coming through the nose. Yeah. Maybe a little bit of nuttiness coming in too. It's overall nice, I mean. When you smoke it regularly, you get a regular nutty taste. You don't get the citrusy sting as much. It's like a creamy nuttiness now, again. It's a very nice smoke, though. I recommend it. Not many places have it, though, around me. Well, one place has it, but I won't go back there before because I was profiled. It was an Indian-owned business. They thought I stole something in there before. And so yeah, I'm not going back to those franchises, but they have this. But another shop also had it too that I went into in another town when I went shopping for cigars. Overall, very good taste though. And I'll update as this goes again. I'm back now. I got the head like up to here, like about maybe 2 inches in or something like that. The burn is even. It was canoeing a little bit on me. I had to puff it at the bottom, a certain end of it, I think around here or something. And I evened it out again. It's zigzagging a little, but it's the type of tobacco that tends to even out easier. You don't have to touch it up or nothing. It just evens out, you know. Nice mild leaf, a delicate leaf, I would say. There's a crack right there. It's more just a sign that the tobacco is delicate. You gotta burn it just right. Handle it lightly, you know. still stay at all. It's a very mild smoke. Even going toward the end, it's got a little complexity, but at the same time, it's very plain and light. But it isn't totally bland, you know. You can still have moments in here that things really pop out at you. So that's good. Still staying on. It's got like losing a little bit of its creaminess though. Getting a little more tar tasty. But it also has some flavors in it too though. It's just not as smooth as it was. That makes sense. But then I could go into another layer toward the end, and it might be, so it's kind of weird. But it's overall got that mild, nutty taste right now. Maybe developing a bit more of an earthy taste. Let's try the retrohale one more time. It's getting more citrusy, actually. Yeah, nice light spice and citrusy, but it's making me saliving right now. Oh, geez. Oh. All right, then. Let's see here. That one tastes a little smooth again. It tries to be a consistent cigar. That's what I find. It tries to be consistent, and I think it is. Great smoke output, as you see. It does the job. I'll probably film one more video, and I'll end it for the day. I'm back for the final. It's down to here now. About to take the band off soon. Friday morning. Just enjoying things. It's going to be a nice sunny day again. It's a little cold out. Cigar's still holding on. I'm getting a little bit of a taste of onion in it now. A little bit of onion. Onion, nuts, spice. It's settling down at the end. Very good. Gonna remove the band here. Came with two bands. Nice setup here. Good presentation on it for something that's simple. No fuss with this cigar. It's like a classic Havana type of a taste, you could say. Very nice and mild. But it's not flavorless at all. That's the thing. It's decent. I've got trouble putting it down, if that says anything. The ash getting darker over here. It's got some nice coloration. But I think it was aged a little bit, too. The before I get it. So if I ever buy these again, it could be 6 months away. They could be more aged if it's the same box and people aren't buying them. Who knows? That happens a lot too, when they sit there, you know. Some people, they have their mind on getting certain ones, and that's what they get, and then they leave others to age a while, you could say. I pay attention to that stuff when I go shopping for them. I do. And you get good at that over time when you smoke these enough of the time. With very even burns still, it's holding together well, you can tell. Holding together well, you can tell. But yeah, that's it right now. It's getting a little bit more of a deep taste, like a deep oniony earth. Right now. Onion, earth, and spice, I would say, are the predominant flavors in this right now. Again, nice coloration on it. Alright, I guess that'll conclude it. Tampa Rollers Churchill. It's probably about an hour and a half smoke. I'm over an hour in now, probably an hour and 5 minutes, I guess is a safe guess. It'll last you over an hour. Safely. Wow, it's all black in here. That's a nice coloration. Look at that. Nice coloration.